A helmet-to-helmet hit on the football field Friday night, and KCRA 3 was there to catch it on camera. And today, we're asking questions about why there wasn't an ambulance on the property at the time and why one didn't show up for a full 15 minutes. That player you saw there ended up with a concussion and should otherwise be okay.
But a lot of people are left wondering, why wasn't an ambulance at the game in the first place? KCRA 3's Melinda Meza looked into that today. She joins us live from Lincoln High School in Stockton, where the game was played. Melinda?
That's right. We are live at Lincoln High School, but the home team was Brookside Christian School. Now, we talked to the CIF commissioner today, who says the bylaw states it's recommended for a school or the home team to have every effort to have a doctor or an EMT at a football game. But again, it's recommended and not required.
Statistics show there has been an increase in concussions among high school football players, and that's no different in Stockton. You see here, the quarterback, number 4, Isaiah Horton from Sierra Ridge, hits helmet to helmet with the player from Brookside Christian School. Horton goes down. It was silent in the stands. Some parents say no ambulance in sight for at least 15 minutes.
We had a registered nurse, a fully licensed registered nurse on the sidelines last Friday night, as we would have any time we would have a physician or somebody there that was qualified.
But here at CIF headquarters, the commissioner explains it's up to each school board and each school district to decide whether it's required for medical help to be at a football game.
It varies. I get cautious with those that don't do anything, but some have EMTs there. Some have ambulances there.
The principal at Brookside Christian School says they would not even start a football game without medical personnel, but typically don't go to the lengths of some schools like Stag High in Stockton, which has an ambulance standing by. CIF Commissioner Pete Sacco says that's not the case for all schools. He says having an ambulance on hand could be expensive.
Now, Brookside Christian School does tell us that the school nurse was there at the game, and when she learned that this same student had injuries just a few weeks prior, that's when they decided to call the ambulance in. Now, he also says that some schools are in rural areas and would not be able to have an ambulance at the game the entire time. Reporting live in Stockton, I'm Melinda Meza, KCRA 3 Report.
So, Melinda, got to ask, I mean, given what happened Friday night, did the principal there at Brookside Christian seem to maybe want to take a closer look at how they staff medical personnel?
Yeah, we did ask him that question. We talked to the principal today. He says he felt confident because the school is located very close by, within 2 miles of a fire station. So he believes that student got very good care. But he did say if they were playing an away game, like at a rural school, then that's when they would consider having an ambulance at the field the entire time.
Okay, makes sense. Melinda, live in Stockton, thank you.